Good morning, church. It's lovely to be here this morning. Thank you for the invitation. I see lots of faces that I know. There are several I don't know, and there's some even going back so far as 1986-87, when Ruth, my wife, and I used to run Broomhill Conference Centre down in Devon. And we used to have some good times there. And it was soon after that I joined the ministry which I did for 28 years. I must apologize that my wife is not with me this morning. She would like to have been, but my son had his firstborn child last night. No name yet. We're still waiting for the name. And we look forward to that. This will be our sixth grandchild children. My daughter has five. I did tell her not anymore, please. Five in this today's society is quite a lot. I came from a family of 11 brothers and sisters, and when Ruth and I got married, because Ruth came from a large family too, and I said to her, is it possible, would you mind if we just had two children? And not have a huge family, and we did. We had a son and a daughter. Now, Rebecca, of course, is my daughter. She's married to a young South African. He plays the musician at Newbold Church, and praise God, she was out of the church, but she's now back in the church, and I thank God for that. But Matthew, my son, is not, sadly, in the church. And so, when your prayer time, if you could please pray and ask God would be generous to encourage him to come back. And I'm hoping that this little baby boy, and we've been praying for this little baby boy for the last 9 months, that God would take this little boy for himself. But not only that, his mother and his father too. Because my son's wife and family don't believe in Jesus. Sadly, but Matthew has a background because we taught him from the knee up until the age of 15, 16 when he decided that he wasn't going to walk with God anymore. But we would like to see him in heaven along with us and our other family members. And I'm sure there must be others, mums and dads who are here this morning who have children who don't come to church, and you want them to be here. You want them to be with Jesus. And so I pray by God's grace that he will indeed bring to fruition those promises that he's given to us in this word. Before I start share with you the word of God, I'd like to share a video with you. And before I do that, this is a word of prayer. Our Father God in heaven, I thank you for the privilege and the opportunity of speaking here this morning. But Lord, I don't want to speak my words, I want to speak your word. So I ask that your Holy Spirit will take control of my mind and my heart and my mouth, so that the words that I do speak will come from you and from your word. Please speak to us now. I pray in your name. Amen. Play the video, please.